Hi again everyone, it's Pauline, and in this video, I'll show you how to fully automate your development setup by creating a .gitpod.yaml file for your project. We like to call this concept dev environment as code, and if you're familiar with infrastructure as code as a concept, it's essentially the same thing in that you describe what your development environment would look like and then watch the magic happen. So we can actually do this with Gitpod. Let me show you here with an example of a Next.js repository that I have. So in the terminal, I can type in gp init, and this command initializes and creates that gitpod.yaml file. And this is what our gitpod.yaml file looks like. So over here, you can see tasks. This is where you can make Gitpod run any command required to initialize your project. This typically means installing dependencies, compiling, and starting an application server. Automating this means that you will never have to run these commands again manually, and Gitpod will do that automatically for you every single time you open a workspace with Gitpod. Notice these lines, these dashes. This dash actually opens a completely new terminal. Every terminal has different phases. You've got init, which only runs once when you first initialize your workspace. You also have command. This runs every time you start or restart a workspace. And you can also actually have a before phase, and this will always go before init or the command phase. So you can start to see the sequence of each command. I also want to show you, you can create new terminals using the dash as I mentioned earlier. So we'll just try it out here. So we'll say this is terminal one, and let's create another one called terminal two. And in this one, we'll have an init phase that does npm install. And we'll also have a command phase, which we will start the development server. So npm run dev. Then just for the fun of it, let's also create a third terminal. The port section does exactly what it says on the tin. It exposes ports. So by default, when a port becomes active in your workspace, Gitpod will ask you whether to open a preview or open a new browser tab or ignore that port altogether. In order for you to test the gitpod.yaml file that you just created, you need to commit your changes and push them to a repository and then create a new Gitpod workspace. So we'll just click Gitpod here. And this is creating a completely new workspace. And we should be able to see the three terminals open up, each with its own commands. Here you go. We have our terminal one. We also have terminal three. Terminal two is actually where all the fun was. And this is where we installed all our dependencies, as you can see there. And also started our development environment using port 3000, as we specified here in our gitpod.yaml file. And as you can see, we've got our Next.js app up and running, and we can also open it up here and have it in the browser. But if you'd like it to automatically show up through the browser, you can change this setting right here. As you can see, this YAML file is pretty powerful, and you can do all sorts of different things to configure it to your needs. We also have custom Docker images that you can create, or you can use our own as a base and adds on top of it. I hope you enjoyed the screencast. In the next screencast, I'll be talking to you about how you can personalize your workspace.